Hello again. Based on their titles alone, some of our guests' favorite movies could be Vogue's Mannequin and Dressed to Kill. The watchdog of female celebrity fashions, he is the critical and witty Mr. Blackwell. And now, here's your man of the half hour, Skip E Lowe.
Mr. Blackwell, Richard Zelzer? Is it?
Mr. Blackwell.
Richard
Blackwell, formerly Sylvan Richard Zelzer.
Zelzer. Yeah. That's a nice...
Yeah, it's 1935.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a nice name. I like that name. That's a good...
Brooklyn,
yeah. That's a real Brooklyn name, though.
Yeah.
Yes, I do like that name. It's a good name.
You know, Skip... Number one, I think it's generally known. Zelzer was my mother's husband's name, mm-hmm. who I presumed over the years was my father.
Right.
Only after Mom passed on did I really realize this man was... Well, I knew it sooner, but not from her. I realized he was not my father, and I sort of resented the name Zelzer. But it took me through the road company of Dead End. It took me through Little Tough Guys in Hollywood. It took me back to New York to work with Mayor LaGuardia in a series called Why Children Come to Court. Uh-huh. And then the name changed.
And then you came to Hollywood.
No,
or
I was
were you still in Hollywood
Little
at
Tough
the
Guys
time?
And
several
movies.
Really?
S. Zelzer, then back to New York. And then back here.
I see. And but Howard Hughes has something to do with your career, though.
No, in between.
In between?
There was so much.
Really?
Dick Ellis.
Right.
Dick Ellis was born about 1939. Mm-hmm. One of the first movies Rita Hayworth made. It was called Juvenile Court. It starred Rita Cancino, was the family name.
Right, she's a Spanish dancer.
And Paul Kelly.
Right.
And you know who was the lead dancer with the Cancino family?
No.
This may surprise you.
Go ahead.
Ida Lupino's sister. She was one of the most incredible dancers you've ever seen.
Uh-huh.
And then in 1939, I went back to New York, and I am proud to say I was the only man that Gypsy Rose Lee ever let dance with her on a stage in a show called... I'm sorry to interrupt.
Go ahead.
In a show called Streets of Paris, produced by Michael Todd. As a matter of fact, that was Mike Todd's very first production in New York.
Uh-huh.
He had been a Chicago boy, as you well know.
Right, of course.
And from that day forward, we were very close friends.
Gypsy Rose Lee. Kind of lady.
Michael.
Come on.
And Michael.
What kind of lady was Gypsy, though? God, what a great lady.
Frightened, petrified.
Really?
Of men. Intimidated by men. She was totally safe.
With you?
No. With stage, with the lights.
Oh, I see what you mean, yeah.
But the minute she went into the audience, she had a very private sort of a life, and consequently, you knew she had one or two wonderful private affairs, and this is not a kiss-and-tell show.
Right.
But everyone knows.
Uh-huh.
And Gypsy became very petrified of men, because when she went to San Francisco...
Right.
...and did her own show, if you recall...
Of course.
That time, she didn't want men. She wanted 90% women on her show.
Mm-hmm.
She did have me there twice, mm-hmm. and that was it. Mm-hmm. And then I became very close to June Havoc. These are great ladies, legends. Yeah, but then
June Havoc and Rita Hayworth, Ida Lupino's, and all these people. These are thinking
Rita
about
Hayworth.
These when we
Mae
talk.
Mae West, and then let's think of
Mae West.
Oh. Even more incredible, Marilyn Monroe.
Really?
Inside.
What makes her so incredible, Mr. Blackwell? Everyone's so...
Truth.
Truth?
Truth. Mm. A simple thing called human inner honesty. Today people lie so viciously. They're so plastic. But Marilyn was honest inside. She was desperate. She was lonely. She was sad. She had a little girl locked in her brain. And that little child screamed constantly to let me out. And the only thing that went wrong, really wrong in Marilyn's life, they tried to make her her image. And there has never been, if you think of this, Skip, there's never been a sex image on the screen
since
that died or lived happy. Name me one sex image. Carol Landis. Gene Hollow.
They tried. They tried with Gene.
Gene had it tough.
Tough, yes.
She had it tough all the way.
Right.
Crawford. Turner still very much, thank God, alive, but not happy.
Now she isn't.
Jane Russell could not exist, could not live with the image, that sex image that Howard Hughes constructed for her.
Right.
She couldn't live with it. She denied it. Now these people that have to deny their images on the screen cannot be happy. And I get so mad when people condemn a movie star who has given their soul, their guts, their stomach, their life to a camera, to a script. And because something goes wrong in their life and they flare up or get excited, they're accused of being temperamental, bad people, tough to work with. This is a lot of
baloney. They love to make stars and they love to tear them down. Why do that?
You want to hear something interesting?
Yeah.
Skip, honest.
Yeah.
You spend the first half of your life proving something and winning.
Right.
Maybe winning.
Right.
You spend the second half of your life defending what you just proved.
That's right.
And the very gimmick, here's another thing to remember, the very gimmick that makes you a star is the very gimmick, Skip, that destroys you. I mean, if I'll use myself. Blackwell. Acid. Acerbic.
You use truth, though. So you like the truth.
Yeah, but all these gimmicks that people won't listen, they hear me, but they won't listen. They hear, but they don't listen, Skip.
You think, you don't think they're listening?
No, I think they're listening.
They want to be on your list, though. I'm telling you.
I'm talking about the public.
Okay.
I'm talking about the public.
Even the public wants that.
The public listens, but they don't hear.
Okay.
The women who make the list, 90% of them, adore being on that list. I mean, it's a terrific theatrical coup.
Of course.
This is a fabulous place in one day to get publicity all around the world. Well, I've got to tell you, the other day at a book signing, I know the book.
You got a new book coming
out. Mr. Blackwell's Worst. 30 years
Of
fashion fiascos. I was doing a book signing and some just horror of a woman came up to me angry. I mean angry. And she says to me, Blackwell, you wrote that book just to get publicity, didn't you? I said, no, madam. I wrote the book to keep it a secret. Then she says, well, you just wrote it to make money. I mean, very angry at me about this. And I said, well, let me ask you something. Do you think I wrote the book to lose money? She said, well, why would you be so rude? I said, why is it rude to critique fashion? It's one of the arts. We critique painters, dancers, singers, musicals, plays, directors. Why is it so rude to critique the art of fashion, which has made a total, if I can use the word, ass out of the woman around the world? Why is it Paris is telling us now, if you don't like it, baby, eat cake. If you don't like it, eat it. Terrific. In the book, I have said everything to defend what I believe to be image to the American woman. I say that Madonna with her ice cream cones and the garter belt over the dress
right.
and the corset, terrific, terrific packaging on stage.
She's the greatest pageanter there is.
Terrific.
She's the best.
Terrific.
She's our best PR, everything.
Up there.
Right.
On stage.
Yeah.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but don't bring this into the home. Yes. Don't bring this into a category called fashion.
Right.
It simply is not. Uh-huh. It's a terrific way to present yourself theatrically. Mm-hmm. And what about Prince? You saw what he did at the Emmys?
Yes.
Well,
yes.
What did he do?
What did he do, Mr. Blackwell? First of all, I want to ask you.
It's so funny. He did what I wish I had the nerve to do myself.
What was that?
Well, he cut the back of his pants out, and he has the cutest rear end in town. I'm sure of that. And the guy did all his spins and turns.
Right, right.
And there was this guy with an incredible looking fanny.
Uh-huh.
I mean, the guy's got a great looking rear
right,
end.
Right, right.
Now, this doesn't mean I'm sitting there looking at Prince's rear end, but
right.
I mean, if it's out there to look at, we're going to look. I wish I had one as good as that. I paid a lot of bucks for mine. He got his free.
How did Mr. Blackwell start at that list? The wonderful list of the worst and the best.
Forget the best because no one prints it.
Oh.
No one wants to print
why
it.
Why don't they want to hear the best?
People don't want good news, Skip. Don't you know people like to hear
news.
Horror?
The news, yeah.
I love it when you die. When anyone on L.A. Street, I used to be on Los Angeles Street, 35 years as a designer.
Right.
The big news is who died yesterday. And for 3 days, oh, what a shame.
Oh.
What a pity. The fourth day.
Yes.
What's his name? He died. The fifth day, someone else has to die to give you something to talk about. Someone has to fail.
Right.
If you have a fire, they did it.
Yes.
If you have a robbery, they did it.
Yes.
They want tragedy. They don't want to talk about nice things. They want to talk about that things that are controversial, that are acidy and arrogant. I once said some terrific things about some movie stars and the Queen of England.
Right.
I had made a trip to London. We called a press conference. And I decided, well, this time I'm going to be Mr. Terrific. Okay?
Uh-huh.
There they are, sitting out, holding court, and right. I'm standing there, and I go to the mic, and I have some wonderful, decent things to say about Her Majesty and the royal family,
right.
omitting the fact that I thought a lot of them really needed help.
Right.
Okay. Do you know something? The press sat there like this, going to sleep.
Uh-huh.
I was losing them.
Right.
So I finally said, well, to tell you the truth, I was just testing you. Uh-huh. I wanted to see if you were listening. The Queen looks like...
Right.
Okay. Right away. Writing. Why don't you like the way she dresses? I told them. Why don't you like her hats?
Right.
I told them. Why don't you like the gloves she wears? I told them. And what were the headlines in the English press?
What?
America's acid big mouth tears down our royalty.
How do you feel?
Terrific.
How do you feel when they use those words in print? Big mouth asset, Mr. Blackwell. How do you take that within yourself?
How I take it.
How do you feel about that? I want to know. When
how
it first
I
came,
it.
Really, how do you take that? Because it would hurt me. It really would hurt me. But evidently,
I've got to back up, and I've got to say, well, Blackwell, I tell you what, you've said something.
Right.
You better take the flak back.
Right.
But you see, it's unwarranted when they come, and if they don't want to hear it, don't print it. If they don't want to hear it, don't come.
True, true.
But they are using the same shtick I'm using.
Right.
The only difference is, and I was the mother of negativity. I say the mother of it because I gave birth
you started
to negativity.
It. You certainly did.
They want to use the very same gimmick on me that they think
reverse
I was using without credibility.
Mm-hmm.
But it was credible.
Of course.
When I first saw, let's say, well, let's take Barbara Streisand. When she fell on the steps and her fanny went up in the air, I think it was many, many years ago. And I said it was a horror. It was the fashion fiasco
right,
of the year,
right.
And she made the list. And the line was very simple. I simply said I didn't mind her wearing a see-through outfit if there was anything worth seeing through to.
Exactly.
But the very year I said Catherine Deneuve was one of the best-dressed women in the world, two people printed it.
Uh-huh.
Who I have said who was the best-dressed woman of all time. One
they,
woman.
And they
I bet you'll never guess who it is.
The best-dressed?
Yeah. Yeah, of all time. Who is she?
Well, I don't remember.
Perfection.
Perfection?
Total perfection. You're going to be very surprised. Not because she doesn't deserve it, but only because you would not have suspected I would have noticed.
Right now, you mean?
Now, no. before and before, yeah.
You
yeah,
like
yeah.
Princess Di, don't you? You
I love her. I love her now after 6. I do not like her daytime clothes.
Her daytime clothes.
No, I don't like them. I love her after 6, and I love her arrogance.
Arrogance.
Saying to the Queen, my dear, if you want to visit Queen Victoria's attic, honey, uh-huh. you do it.
Yes.
In the meantime, I have the heir to the throne.
Yes.
So just cool it, baby.
But it's good to have arrogance if you know how to carry it. Am I right?
Who's the best? Come on.
Who is the best?
Who's the best?
I can't remember. I don't know.
Diane Carroll.
Diane Carroll. Absolutely.
Without a doubt.
Yes, she is.
This year, who moved over from awful to wonderful? This year. Bette Midler.
Did she really?
It's, yeah.
Why? Why is that, Mr.
Have
Bartle?
You seen Bette with the new haircut, the new clothes? Have you seen
no,
her?
No, I haven't seen
fabulous
her.
Fabulous she
really.
Looks?
No, no.
She's dynamite.
Is she really?
Streisand
you
has
always,
never improved.
You said if Streisand improves, you would
no,
stop
no,
the
no,
list.
No, 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 no,
wouldn't
no.
You?
No.
Yes,
no,
you did.
No,
you
no,
said
no, I didn't say it that way. Let
okay,
me say
okay, how
it.
Would you say it?
I said if
how did you say it?
If Streisand looks good
yeah.
3 years in a row.
That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
I will give up the list.
Would you really? Would you give up that list?
Well, I promise, so I'd have to
I
do
have
it,
to
yeah.
know. You did not answer me. How did you get that list started? Who suggested
it? The best dressed. Oh,
the best and the worst. How did well, the worst and the best?
The
how
truth about how the best started.
Right.
I needed publicity.
Come on.
No, it's the truth. In 1960.
Right.
American Weekly.
Right.
A Sunday supplement came to me and said, Mr. Blackwell, would you do an article, knowing I had been in show business.
Right.
Will you do an article on the 10 best and 10 worst in Hollywood?
Right.
That was the first, but not a list. Now, I think you have the picture
go ahead.
From 1960, which would be
oh,
very...
Oh, yes, I love to see
which
it.
Which is
yes.
interesting. I hope it's
there. It is. 60.
Okay.
Here, we'll
this
start this
is part or? Of 1960, and this was the beginning...
This is the beginning.
...of what was to become a list, but this was not a list.
I see.
See, this was
yes,
only
yes.
the feature article
uh-huh.
in the American Weekly.
I see.
In 1961, we held a press conference
I'm
and
seeing
tried to continue.
Anna Magnani. Come on. That's my
well,
favorite.
Well, read what
Anna
I said.
Anna Magnani.
Yeah.
I can't read that small, but boy, Anna
well,
Magnani. You give it a shot.
No,
Anna Magnani.
You give it a shot.
Anna Magnani and
well,
Shelley Winters.
Oh, well, Shelley, Shelley.
Shelley never made it on... not this year, but...
Shelley? No, I gave up Shelley.
You gave up Shelley?
She's terrific.
She's great. I love her.
Terrific gal.
You know, she loves to be on your... She says...
She wants
She says,
it.
I want to be on your worst list. If you're not on it, she says people just...
You're nobody.
Yeah.
Do you know Susan Summers said I saved her career? Do you know that Phyllis Diller only got mad at me when I took her off the list?
Did she really?
Yeah, I loved it. Phyllis called me up 3 times, hung uh-huh. up the phone. Phyllis called me up again and said, Mr. Blackwell? I said, yes.
Yes.
She said, this is Phyllis. I said, who? She said, Phyllis. I said, Phyllis who, dear?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I knew.
Right.
So anyway, she said, Phyllis Diller, and all I want to know from you, Mr. Blackwell, is where did I go right? That was all. It was very simple.
That's funny.
Very simple.
1971. Come on, this
well,
is
we
the
go up 10 years, Ally McGraw, you've got here who really, I mean, someone threw her off a gypsy caravan. I can't believe.
Who's that?
That's Ally McGraw.
Ally McGraw, what an outfit.
That's a dreadful thing. There's wonderful pictures in this book.
Yes. Dinah Shore. Tell me about Dinah Shore.
Oh, that poor thing.
What is sad?
Hopeless.
Really?
Hopeless. Mm-hmm. You know, you know what's so amazing? I had a review
uh-huh.
in a local... paper.
Right.
No, a good paper. I mean, the paper.
Right.
They said it was the worst book they ever read.
You're kidding.
I said, thank you. How terrific of you. Because they said, we uh-huh. have never seen a book
uh-huh.
with uglier pictures. Dummies, didn't they know this was a worst-dressed book? This was not intended to be a book of photographs done by Hurrell, making glamour photographs.
Now, last...
I was so grateful for it.
Last night, you were at the... they were honoring Miss Hollywood, Miss Debbie Reynolds.
Debbie, was she terrific?
Now, you're glancing out this whole arena. Come
all
on,
right.
Seeing all these gowns, Mr. Blackwell.
All right, last night,
come
my
on,
feeling...
I want to know your feeling with these gowns.
They were terrific.
Some of them were great, weren't they?
Skip, they were terrific.
Really?
Women have revolted. Women are saying, I want to be beautiful. Women are now dressing beautifully.
Where are you?
Women are down to the floor.
Yes.
You know, there are certain codes. Black tie, in my opinion, means formal gown.
Right.
To the floor.
Right.
I don't give a darn what the industry tells you. Black tie optional is another category.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, this means you can wear a short, formal, possibly strapless, very dressy. Then there's a thing called dressy, which means you can go to an affair wearing a wonderful dinner suit or a very, very chic dinner dress.
Right.
And then there's casual or just business attire. Well, you wear always wear a tie.
Right, of
By
course.
All means. If
you'd love to see women, very femme women, don't you? Women who look like they should dress like women.
I like to see
women.
You
resent women who don't dress like women. Is that right, Mr. Blackwell?
I resent the intimidation by the industry. I don't resent the women.
What do you mean by the...
These women are intimidated.
Like?
Well, fashion comes out with a statement.
Right.
Micro minis, balloon mini skirts, or gypsy clothes or hooker clothes or whatever it might be, whatever Saint Laurent said, whatever LaCroix said, whatever anyone said, they will wear it even if they know it's ugly because they're so afraid that their peer group, the other woman sitting over there who couldn't give a, you know, a baker's dozen damn, who couldn't care less.
Exactly.
She's so afraid that woman isn't going to approve of her that she's got to wear what's in all of the fashion Bibles. It was a saying done by Coco Chanel.
The best.
I despise the word fashion. I love the word fashionable women.
That's the word.
That's the word.
That's actually the word. I love that word. I just adore it.
They were gorgeous.
Actually, you like to see women dress for men. Women should dress for men, not for themselves, just for another woman. That's what's happening.
Skip, I like to see women dress for their own self-esteem. I want to see women look beautiful because they want to tell the world, I am beautiful. And I think it's a terrific thing to do. I see nothing wrong with telling a woman, you're absolutely gorgeous.
Exactly.
And I love it, and I want to light her cigarette, and I want to put her on a pedestal. I want to open a door for her.
I think that's great.
I want to make it all the things that's right.
That's why they use Mr. Blackwell, because you are a mister. And that's what I like about you. Well, Dolly Parton, come on. Tell me about Dolly.
Dolly is very much like Marilyn was. Do you know that?
Uh-huh. Dolly was really...
And a lot like Jane Mansfield was.
Oh, I like
that. All three had the same childlike emotional attitude. Dolly is dressing up in every fantasy idea she ever had as a baby, as a child.
Right.
As a child, she had nothing. She had no pretty clothes. They weren't well off. She barely had the right clothes to put on.
Right.
So Dolly had fantasy. So when she grew up, all of this has become a cartoon of her fantasy.
Right.
So I simply commented that she looked like the Allegheny Mountains covered in sequins. It wasn't really too bad a line.
I know.
And of course then we have the
Elizabeth
10 worst.
Is Elizabeth Taylor in the 10 best worst?
Of three decades, But this year she looked great.
Did you like her this year?
Yes, very much, except a couple of... No, I didn't like the yellow.
The yellow gown.
No, I didn't like it.
That's what I want to ask you.
No.
Wait, I'm going to turn this a minute.
No, I
didn't
like
it.
No. I didn't like her playing Cinderella.
That's what it was.
I didn't like her being Scarlett O'Hara.
what it was.
But I mean, she's walking this guy down that she gave a bath to.
Who made that gown anyway?
Valentino. It's a beautiful gown.
It's a gorgeous gown. Gorgeous gown. But not for that particular moment.
I mean, I got to tell you, I'd have looked better in it.
I bet you would.
No, I would. I'm teasing.
Here, let's see this. This is the 10.
This is the 10 top worst of 3 decades.
Okay.
Madonna, Sinead O'Connor, who is really a nightmare. You have Mia Farrow here. You have Shelley.
Shelley Winters.
Shelley made it.
She loves it.
Dolly Parton. You have Streisand. Definitely. You have Elizabeth Taylor, you have Roseanne Barr, you have Cher, and you have the wonderful Queen of England.
Those Roseanne are your Barr, ten. I want to come on. Let's talk about Roseanne Barr.
I haven't got much to say about
you
Roseanne.
You don't? I don't know. I'll tell you why.
Something isn't connecting.
I think she's joking. I think she's laughing at everybody.
You really think she's laughing?
I think she's having a fun with American people.
I don't think she's having fun at all. I think she enjoys ripping it off. Everything.
That's it.
I am told on the set she is not one of the most wonderful creatures in the world to work with, but then maybe it's tough on the set. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But Roseanne is looking a little bit better. A little better. She's getting her act together, but I want to see this act together.
Yes.
As far as I'm concerned, I'm not going to mention Roseanne again.
What does... Madonna think of she loves you. She wants to be on that list. Madonna loves it.
She loves it.
She loves it. I know she does.
She does.
She does, huh?
What would she think if I took her off the list? She would get so mad. You know what she said?
Shelley Winters said she would get mad. She told me that.
You know what Madonna said, and I think
what?
It's terrific. Madonna said, of all the uncertainties in the world, things I cannot depend on, there's one thing I can depend on. That's making Mr. Blackwell's worst dress list. So, it's okay with me.
That's great.
She's terrific.
Tell me about your 10 worst, the 32 years you've been...
30 years of 30
years of the worst...
Dressed women.
Dressed women. This book is out right now. The fashion... Oh, I think it's a great book.
It's a fun book.
It's a fun book?
Smile a page. And you know what? You got to read this book without being defensive. Don't be defensive. Enjoy this realizing that I'm only critiquing the clothes they're wearing.
Right.
I'm not pulling down the stars.
You're having fun, would you say, Mr. Blackwell, in life right now? Look back. Look.
Am I having fun now?
Aren't you?
Skip.
You are.
Let's see.
Come on. You are having fun. You mean you've been in the business? You've had a great life.
I will have.
Would
more
you say
fun.
You're having a good? Fun right
I'm
now.
Going to have more.
You're
going to
have more?
Yeah, I want to go back to Broadway.
Go ahead.
I want to do cabaret.
You do?
I want my biography done, which will be done in about a year. I want to see this book very successful. Because it's 30 years of my life. And I also want to see the biography done, made into a movie, hopefully a play. And then I would like to go back to Broadway and do a
Who would you
a
like to see
part.
Someone? Is there someone out there right now that you would like to see?
No.
No, right now, no.
I don't think so.
Looking back.
I don't think there's anyone there.
Right.
I would prefer an unknown. Because anyone who's a name, anybody, you're not going to believe it's Blackwell. So if we get a totally new face, one that's been restored.
Right. Tell me about your face. You had a face job.